Hello everybody, it's Nantos Commander, and welcome to episode 40 of Pokemon Battle Zone. As always, here is another friend match I had against my friend Dinnerman12 from YouTube, and as per usual, I will put a link to his channel in the description down below. If you enjoy what I post, then please go check him out. You might very well enjoy what he posts as well. So, let's get into the battle. He leads off with a Rotom Heat form. I've got my Tornados, but he immediately uses Volt Switch and goes out into his Jirachi. But I went straight in for the Dark Pulse, which is good for me, because that's going to do a lot of damage to Jirachi, but he actually has the leftovers. I can't say if this is going to 2-hit KO, from the looks of things it will, but it doesn't matter anyway, because he's going to switch right out and go back into his Rotom Heat form. And I'm going to now use Dark Pulse, but I am going to die this turn due to the Life Orb, since I'm using Life Orb and I've not got enough life to survive the recoil, so I lose my Tornadoes pretty early on in the battle. So I'm now going to bring in my Arcanine, which doesn't really matter with the Intimidate, because clearly Rotom Heat Form is a special attacker. He's now going to go out into his Altaria, which is actually bad for me, because I actually did predict the switch. I went for close combat, but I didn't bank on him going out into Altaria, which ultimately led to me doing not too much damage with close combat. I really should have gone for something like Wild Charge or something that wasn't resisted by Altaria. But whatever, I'm going to go out into my Vaporeon. I selected Vaporeon because I was pretty confident he was going to go Mega Evolve into Mega Altaria. And with my amazing special defense with Vaporeon, I can pretty much take a Hyper Voice without too much difficulty. In fact, it looks like it's going to be around a 4 or 5 hit KO. But I do carry the leftovers and I also carry the Wish, so I'm pretty sure I could have stalled that thing out. But he does go out into Jirachi, which I'm assuming he was predicting the Toxic. But I actually went for the Wish because I was expecting him to go for another Hyper Voice on the next turn. But whatever. So I'm now going to face off against his Jirachi once again. And unfortunately I'm unable to use Toxic on this thing because it's a Steel type. And I really should learn to carry Scald. I actually carry Hydro Pump for some weird reason. So that's weird. And I bring in my Bisharp now, and I don't know why I went into Bisharp, come to think of it. I assume I was predicting some sort of Psychic type attack, like maybe Psy Shock or maybe Psychic, but obviously Bisharp is immune to both those moves. So anyway, he's going to go back into his Altaria now, and I'm going to go for Knock Off. I actually learned via Bulbapedia that apparently the knockoff boost, the 1.5 boost that comes with the opponent holding an item, doesn't actually apply to Mega Stones. Apparently it only applies to items that can actually be knocked off. So that's a shame. And as a result, he actually carries the Fire Blast. I really didn't predict that in the slightest, so that was really cool on Kevin's part. But now I'm going to bring back in my Vaporeon, since I know I can soak up hits from that thing all day. He's now going to bring in Deku Ghost, which is a pretty cool name, reference to the Deku Tree from Zelda, obviously. But I do go for the Toxic, and this means now I've got some consistent damage going on at the end of every turn. So I get the Leftovers Recovery, and I think on the next turn, I'm pretty much just going to Toxic Stall this thing with Protect and Wish, and of course the Toxic damage. And on the occasional turn, I might go for Hydro Pump just to get off a bit of extra damage. But I think for the most part, I can leave the damage pretty much up entirely to the Toxic, while continuing to support myself with Leftovers and Wish. However, he also does carry the Leftovers, apparently, so that's a thing. So there goes the Toxic damage, but obviously realizing that I technically do kind of hold the advantage, he's going to go out into his Cordaunt, which is kind of cool. I'm assuming he was predicting some sort of attacking move, maybe Hydro Pump or Scald or something like that. But I'm going to go for the Wish on this turn, so that's fun. So he's going to go for the Dragon Dance this turn, which I pretty much was predicting, since that's really what Cordaunt needs to do in order to be effective, since its speed is not the best in the world. So realizing this, I decided to go ahead and use the turn to Toxic damage, and now just like with Trevenant, I pretty much can go ahead and just Toxic Stall this thing. Although I must confess, I probably won't survive as long against Cordaunt as I would against the Trevenant, because, well, Vaporeon's defense stat is pretty decent, but it's not amazing by any means. And compared to Cordon's boost from Dragon Dance, well, let's just say I'm not going to take a hit very well. And in fact, I'm actually going to get one hit KO'd because of the 1.5 boost that is given from Knockoff, as well as the boost from Life Orb and Dragon Dance. But at least I was able to toxic it, so at least I'm doing some sort of damage to this thing every turn. But fortunately for me, since his speed stat isn't the best in the world and I do have the Intimidate drop, I'll bring in my Arcanine, which is in fact Choice Scarfed, and I can go ahead and use Wild Charge to get rid of this thing rather easily. I would have just bought in right away, but I really didn't want to risk getting hit by that thing on my Arcanine, since there is a chance it may have been able to have KO'd me, or at least have done a lot of damage to me. So he brings in Diggersby, which still pretty cool, I must say. I should really consider getting myself one of those. And I bring in my Simisage, but to tell you the truth, I pretty much brought in Simisage just as Death Fodder because I had no idea what it was going to do. So I essentially just went straight out into that and Death Foddered it to see what would happen. So he brings in Altaria now, and I go straight out into my Gallade, which is not too good for me, because Mega Altaria does have really good stats. But at this point, I think this is the last Pokemon I've got in my lineup, apart from Arcanine, so I really do need to be careful in what I'm using here. I go ahead and use the Zen Headbutt. It's doing a good chunk of damage, actually, and I do luckily get my hands on the flinch from Zen Headbutt, so that is actually pretty nice for me. So he brings in his Jirachi now, and this is obviously going to do absolutely nothing because it's a 4x resistant to psychic type attacks. So I'm going to just sit here while he gets his leftovers recovery, and now I'm just going to go straight in for the close combat, and this is going to do a good chunk, but I don't think he was going to KO since this is a Jirachi after all. And he goes for Wish. Of all things, he goes for the Wish, which really did surprise me. I was expecting Psychic or Psyshock or anything of that nature, but no, apparently not. He's going to go for the Wish, which means essentially now I can just KO this thing with a close combat. Maybe he was predicting for me to switch to go out into something else, so he thought I was going to do that and then he could Wish on that turn, but I guess, you know, if things didn't go the way he was expecting. So he brings in Altaria and then immediately switches out, which I'm guessing was a misclick, but okay, this is weird. So I'm going to now use Zen Headbutt once again. This is going to do a good chunk of damage because it is a Trevenant, but actually, that actually was a critical hit apparently, which, you know, if that had been a normal hit, that wouldn't have done that much damage in the long run. So that was actually pretty lucky on my part that I actually was able to get the critical hit. But of course this turn, I just want to go ahead and use Shadow Sneak and get rid of this thing right away. So in comes Diggersby, and this could actually be a problem because now, you know, I've already lost quite a few defenses to the close combats, and I really don't want to take a quick attack right to the face since it will do a lot of damage. So I bring in my Arcanine now, and just to reduce the damage as much as I can. Of course, quick attack is going to do a decent amount of damage, but nowhere near enough to knock me out. He brings back in Altaria, which of course is still bad for me because I actually thought he would predict me thinking he was going to go out into Altaria and as a result stay in. So I went for the close combat, but lo and behold, he does end up going straight in for Altaria, which sucks for me because now I'm locked straight into it and I certainly can't switch out into the Mega Gallade. But if I'd known he was going to roost, I actually would have gone straight out into Mega Gallade, and then I would have basically got on a free turn because I think I carry the Stone Edge with my Mega Gallade. But he's going to go for Hyper Voice, and even with the resistance, with the fact that I've used close combat twice, there's no way I'm going to be able to survive that. So I might as well just go ahead and bring in Gallade, and now I can just go ahead and use Zen Headbutt. This definitely will KO because it's coming from a Mega Gallade. He hasn't got that much life left, so now I can get rid of this thing. But now I've got a problem because He's still got his Rotom Heat form, which is actually been here since the start of the battle, and since he's Choice Scarfed, that means now I'm going to take an overheat straight to the face, and now he's probably going to bring in his Diggersby and go ahead and use Quick Attack, which could probably KO me since it has huge power, it gets stab boost, and yeah, that's pretty much game for the most part. And I severely doubt I'm going to survive a Quick Attack with Mega Glade's rather mediocre defenses. So, good game, Kevin. This was actually a really close match. So, as always, if you want a link to Kevin's channel, you will find it in the description down below. And also, there's an annotation link on your screen right now to the previous episode, as well as Kevin's channel. Please check him out if you haven't already. He actually does post pretty fun videos. As for me, I will see you in the next episode. Peace.